AMDS provides a structure that will ensure nationally consistent data collection. This means stakeholders can manage local roads or state highways and can collect better quality data, helping them meet their asset management goals.
AMDS is a common language that describes the service, impacts and asset lifecycle across the transport system. It supports how we make asset management decisions within a road controlling authority and across the sector.
The Asset Management Data Standard is a collaborative program between Waka Kotahi New Zealand Transport Agency and the transport sector. It will improve how the transport sector manages and shares information about our infrastructure assets.
Supplier organisations will benefit from the use of a common language across the transport sector, which will make processes more efficient and deliver better results. An example of this is AMDS will make contract implementation easier because all road controlling authorities will eventually have the same data structure and lookups. AMDS will help data be more predictable, making it easier to transfer between systems.
By having better quality asset data, road controlling authorities can consider the criticality of the asset to plan the type of intervention. For example, do I replace or do I maintain this asset? Road controlling authorities can share lessons learned, compare asset decisions, and best practice can be benchmarked across the sector.
For Waka Kotahi, AMDS supports better allocation of national funding and ensures regional transport needs are understood and prioritised. Having complete and consistent data improves our understanding of the network and ensures trends are identified early. This enables cost-effective asset management decisions. When everyone is talking the same language, it will help the sector communicate effectively. Implementation of AMDS is road controlling authority led. This means that RCS will manage their implementation of the new data standard. Implementation of AMDS has been split into 10 tranches and phased over 5 years. It is expected that all RCS will be using AMDS by June 2027.
Although Auckland Transport is in a later tranche, we have started early planning for how we will implement AMDS. Key things for us are identifying the systems and reports that use asset data and understanding if they may need to be updated to align with AMDS. Being in a later tranche means we can take the lessons learned from the earlier tranches and apply them to our implementation.
As suppliers, we're working with multiple councils who will adopt AMDS at different times over the next 5 years. As a member of the AMDS reference group, we've gained insights into the implementation approach. This allows us to plan for this and work with our customers to ensure their adoption of AMDS is a success. Downer is also working with Waka Kotahi to help design the standard. This includes markings, stopping places and ITS assets. By working with the sector to shape the standard, Waka Kotahi is making sure the standard is fit for use across the sector.
Auckland Transport is a member of the dedicated AMDS reference group. The group is made up of organisations from all around the country and across the sector and gives us a direct channel to provide feedback to the implementation process. Together, we've been able to openly discuss challenges and work together to find solutions.
The data standard supports the consistent capture of defects, which helps with better planning, prioritisation and scheduling of work. Because the data standard is spatial, it enables the ready use of spatial analytics across all New Zealand's transport networks. With more rapid advances in analytics tools in the transport sector, this will lead to better modelling, richer scenario testing and forecasting, and better targeting of activities to improve customer service.
The standard is being developed to support the complete asset management lifecycle, which means in the future, we can monitor trends, impacts, service performance and asset condition. This means we'll have a better understanding of when and why maintenance, renewal and improvement activities are needed, what different works can achieve and their cost, and how they should be designed and scoped to address all service defects and outcomes. AMDS is intended to support current and future multimodal networks and reflect the planning and design activities around that for asset management.
Applying the standard to data creation from the planning and design onwards will make the handover of data to maintenance and operations far easier. By starting with a specification of the data we will need at the end, and collecting asset data in a standardized way from the beginning, the handover process is a further milestone in the data collection and reporting journey. AMDS enables a digital future. We are creating conformity in service and asset data so that digital engineering processes and analytics can be widely applied across the sector.